come, baby. Just win, baby. Feel the storm of the cold autumn wind, baby. It's the Oakland Raiders. Get your mouthpiece.
Through the draft, and especially this cut down, he told me they might be able to find the 52nd or 53rd player on this roster, or at least build the practice squad up. Reggie will be very busy over the weekend. Back to you, Beth.
Yeah, they've got some work to do in the next 48 hours or so. This is Atkinson. Getting out to the 25-yard line and a pickup of about 9 for George.
Well done for George Atkinson. Beth, it seems like I say this every week.
You're in his fan club.
He always plays well. He's just that guy looking for a home. But, yeah, I mean, open field tackle, the guy's got to make that tackle. He just makes a miss, a little sidestep, he's back underneath and sets up second and one. Good special teams player, catches the ball well, good protector.
On second and one of the big decisions perhaps for Reggie will be how many running backs do you keep on the roster? This is Atkinson again with his head down. It looks like he's got the first down yardage, but you know, last year with Tywan Jones, I think there were 5 on the roster. Do you stick with just Lynch, Washington, Richard, and Olawale?
That's probably
what they only go with 4.
Yeah, and then you're going to go with 3 tight ends. I think the big difference, of course, is Marshawn Lynch.
Oh, yeah.
Lynch gives him some toughness. I think Todd Downing is very comfortable with the first group. But in this league now, you've got to have depth, and that's the hardest thing to get. Because of the salary cap, and, you know, that kind of restricts some things.
Connor Cook, who is the quarterback on this series, finds Keon Hatcher on the out route for a pickup of about 6. Connor has had decent numbers the last 2 preseason games for the Raiders to put a little pressure on Manuel in front of him.
Well, one thing, Beth, is very obvious. There's Carr, and then there's a gap. And so this team will go as far as Derek Carr and this offense can take them. This defense is a work in progress. It needs to get better. One of the things Reggie's going to be doing is, in my opinion, I'd be looking for some linebacker help because they don't have it.
Atkinson tries to get to the outside, can't get there. Good job by the Seahawks to stretch it out. Did they force another fumble here? Shea Palacio, the second-year man out of Washington State, and Marcus Smith were the defenders closest. They'll say that Atkinson was down, no gain. So that's going to set up a 3rd and 3.
The ball was actually out.
Yes, it was.
The ball was out, but I wonder if you didn't hear a whistle.
I think there it is. There's the challenge flag because it appeared that Atkinson was on top of a defender, so it wasn't in contact with the ground when the ball popped free. Raiders have already fumbled once tonight. John Crockett, that resulted in 3 points for Seattle.
Yeah, see, he's on top of the pile. None of his body touches, and the ball is free. Who picked it up? Did Seattle recover that?
I think that's what they're going to have to determine here. Palacio was the guy that jarred it loose.
So they're saying that he was down by contact? That's...
Seattle is challenging the rule on the field that the runner was down before the ball came out.
Okay, then they'll win that challenge.
We got to see who recovered it, but it appeared that Seattle did come out with it.
But if, now you can't hear the whistle and the play's still moving, so they would, it'll be a fumble.
Let's see, does the knee come down? No, it does not.
He doesn't touch anything.
Lands right on top of Cachet.
Ball's flopping
in
right
the
there.
Scrum. Yeah, Seahawks got it. That 39, Demetrius McCray, I think, is the guy that will come out with it. Trip for Clay Martin over to that new instant replay tablet. Boy, that's something too. Your staff, your coaching staff, whoever your eye in the sky is for your team, right on top of that, and the Seahawks certainly were.
That's an important guy. He's up in the booth. He's talking to the head coach with the flag. That's a big deal. It's interesting. I was on the competition committee for 7 years, and one of the things they tried to keep out of the game was new technology. And we were just talking about it before the game, and the new technology has just gotten into the game.
Yep.
Now, it was never a big deal with this replay. That was part of it. But where you see it now, they have the iPads on the sidelines. And everything's instant. There's
the instant replay tablets.
Or whatever you want to call them. I don't know what they call them. I can't even use a stupid phone my wife bought me.
That is the Raider defense that is now trotting out onto the field. They may know something that we don't, as Martin still is over there at the tablet. One of the things that they continue to work on is pace of play, the flow of the game, and to not spend a whole lot of time. My guess is they've already decided that it will be Seattle ball, and now are looking for where to spot it, because the Seattle offense is now trotting out onto the field as well. If this is the case, a sloppy first quarter for Oakland with a pair of fumbles by their running backs. It's a Seattle defense that was not very good against the run a year ago. In fact, ranked 25th in the league. Excuse me, a very good rush defense. Apologize. Total defense and scoring defense with that group. They have stripped it out twice now here in the first half.
After review, the ball did come out prior to the runner coming down. However, there was no clear recovery. It will be Oakland ball, third down. Wow. Seattle will be charged for their first timeout.
So they couldn't determine who recovered, which is interesting. You don't see that very often.
No.
Normally, somebody picks it up and holds on to it. That's the way it is. But and we saw it there. That's why we were asking who had their hands on it. And the answer was D, nobody.
Well, fascinating, because both teams thought that it was going to be Seattle ball.
Yeah.
So a break there for the Raiders to get it back. Atkinson will return out there with the Raiders offense and Connor Cook. Second-year man out of Michigan State, who was the starter for Oakland last year in their playoff game against Houston after Derek Carr and Matt McGloin both went out with injuries. Carr, the broken leg on Christmas Eve, and then McGloin the following week went into the concussion protocol. Incomplete, looking for K.J. Britt.
Yeah, nice switch coverage. Khalil Hill right there. He was on the corner. He went a Z-short motion back inside, and then they switched. The corner dropped off to play over the top, and Hill just picked him up and ran with him. That's really good coverage. That's a coverage that the Seahawks have been running for a while. Well done.
Fourth and three, so Marquette King back out there. Kissick is the deep man at the 50. JD with the fair catch right around the 13-yard line. A 53-yard out there.
14 yards on that kickoff return. First and 10 for the Raiders.
This Raider offense got to get something going, even if it's a short underneath pass game or... The Seattle defense plays nice tight coverage. They always have. That's one of the things that beat stresses this defense, and that's what they get.
It's a nice cut to get to the outside, and then back to the middle. Jags going first down.
This was designed to go inside, and then he cut it back to the outside, was able to get the edge. So you're going to see this on the top side. A couple of blocks, here's the key. Now he has, you know, you can see it's a free shot. Nico Thorpe had the free shot to be able to make that tackle, and Atkinson just ran right past him.
That was a nice block by K.J. Brent.
Yeah.
Out on the edge, Atkinson. Four carries, 21 yards so far tonight. That's a Gabe Holmes now in a tight end. Robert McDougal with the tackle.
Yeah, you have to be decisive once you get the ball. You got to believe your eyes. Stick your foot and go. You start dancing a little bit, everybody recovers way too fast on the defensive side.
Well, the other thing, not only are you're watching Atkinson, but also these frontline guys. You don't have the starters in, which when they're all together is one of the best in the NFL. But who are going to be those backups? You got a guy like Vidal Alexander on the outside, John Feliciano on the inside, and then there are jobs to be won. Cook, pass is incomplete. Intended for Brent, and it's third and eight.
And he and Cook has to get on the same page for that. That's that back shoulder throw. You have to, that's stuff you got to work on and have really good timing with. There's Mike Tice, the offensive line coach of the Raiders. He's done a really nice job. He's also developed some depth, which is what he's trying to look for right now with this offensive line.
He played for the Seahawks for a while. Played end up in Seattle. There's one of the guys, Ian Silverman. And will he possibly be the backup behind Hudson and Feliciano in the middle? Cook with some time. Incomplete. Well behind K.J. Brent, but a flag down in the backfield.
Probably a hold. They'll decline it.
Holding. Offense number 71. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
That's the youngster, David Sharp.
Who's athletic, he's got good length, he just needs experience, and Mike would have to be the guy to work with him with that. And if he takes a spot, then he'll get it every day, and if he gets on a practice squad, he'll get the same thing.
He was helping to protect Jack Del Rio's son.
Yeah.
He was the starting quarterback for a while last year at Florida.
Lost it.
Marquette King, McKissick. Fields it on the run, gets by the first wave, and dances out across the 40 to about the 44-yard line. 14 yards on the tailback. Play action from Connor Cook, and a big hit. And flags are flying on the pass breakup, on the throw to Keon Hatcher, who's got a touchdown catch tonight.
It's Kendrick Thompson right in the middle of the field. He led with his head, right to the neck and head. They're going to call that every time.
Making his way over to the sideline. Appears to be okay.
Defense number 33. Hit on a defenseless receiver. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Yeah, he's throwing him down in there. He's gonna go dig that thing out. That's a picture of the rule right there.
That's an easy call to make. Stop. This is something new you're going to see around the NFL. There will be a medical person wearing a red hat, and this is a pop-up medical tent where they will take, you can take players in there to look at any kind of injury, but if the medical personnel in the red hat goes into that tent, which he did, that means they are looking at the possibility of a concussion. And, they are checking out Keon Hatcher. something new you'll see around the NFL. Atkinson with the catch, and he's got the first down.
He went in with one of the Raider doctors, Mandeep Singh, who's excellent. So
we have 29 medical personnel at every NFL venue.
It's amazing, really.
The league continues to work on safety issues. And
but there are things, and there's a flag in that one that are taken against the Seattle Seahawks. There are occasional major issues that come up that nobody knows anything about. Looks like Hatcher's fine.
Yeah, there's good news for the Raiders. He has come out of that
Rob Morris
medical tent. Yep, ready to get back in. So he has passed the tests that were conducted underneath that tent.
Timeout. Timeout.
Yep.
Oakland, their first. 30-second timeout.
And you see Jack Del Rio reminding Cook, come on now. Got to be cognizant of that clock. I think Raider Nation really anxious to see Todd Downing in his debut calling plays in that season opener. Remember, he's been around the game a long time. He's been with the Raiders for 3 years, but when they are at Tennessee Sunday morning, September 10th, that will be his first live action as the OC.
Well, let me tell you something about offensive coordinators. You either have it or you don't. Play callers, they have just a natural thing, or they don't have it. I think he's got it, but he's also got two flags down at this point.
I think they're going to get Ian Silverman here.
Holding offense number 64. 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
Not going to be on Silverman. That'll be on Chauncey Briggs, the rookie out of SMU. A lot of penalties against Dallas last week. 7 more of them tonight. Raiders were the most penalized team in the league last year.
Well, back in the day, we would be the most penalized, and we'd also win the world championship, so I'm just throwing that out there.
Okay. It's not always a major deterrent.
Pressure.
Cook.
Nice pick up,
complete, intended for KJ Brent.
Good
that
coverage.
Was Nico Thorpe.
Yeah, nice coverage by Nico Thorpe. They came with a blitz on the inside, nicely picked up inside, and then watch Thorpe get him to the outside, and the ball was just not thrown well.
Keon Hatcher back out there for the Raiders. It's 2nd and 20 from the 30-yard line. Cook will work out of the gun. There's Keon, who's already got a 19-yard touchdown catch tonight. Delayed handoff to Atkinson, motoring down inside the 20, still going to the 16 for George, and a 14-yard gain.
Nice little play call. Play call you're expecting. They have man coverage. He shows the fake up top first. It gets the defenders to kind of give a little bit, especially second level, and then Atkinson's off to the races.
Gives him a much more manageable 3rd and 6. George, by the way, tonight, 7 carries, 40 yards. Cook, incomplete, nearly intercepted.
Not
looking for Holton.
Yeah, Holton, had he let him, he had a chance. That ball was still behind.
Pierre Desir was actually the closest guy to it, the DB. And it's 4th down. Giorgio Tavecchi will come on to try and tie this game for the Raiders. should be a 34-yard attempt. Giorgio's make so far in the preseason was from 43 yards out. And he's got it. The Raiders tie it up 10 apiece, 8:13 to go here in the third quarter in the fourth and final preseason game. I get my Raider news each and every day, including the big news this week. Seth Roberts, as we told you earlier this week, got a new contract extension. The slot receiver's going to be around for a few more.
Too well done on the outside.
KJ Brent did a nice job with that right side. He took that defender up, and then it's a back shoulder throw, and he comes back to it exceptionally well. This is really hard to defend right here.
Cook to Brent.
Nice job by that crew out there.
Yep.
Camera crew did a nice job getting that put you down.
Had one catch through the first three games this preseason. He's got three of them tonight. As we heard Jack Del Rio tell Nicole at halftime, providing more tape for us to watch and make some decisions off the deflection. Falls incomplete, intended for Atkinson.
He's lucky it wasn't picked.
Second and 10. Cook 3 for 10 tonight, 33 yards. KJ Brent incomplete. And now it's 3rd and 10. Cook not having his best outing of the preseason. And a touchdown pass in the game against the Rams. Looked solid against Dallas last week.
So it's kind of a simple concept. While you're on the left side, you're taking all your receivers and you're clearing them. You're taking Atkinson from the bottom slot, and you're just making him, you know, you got one-on-one against swoops. And you're saying, he's going to keep outside leverage. I'm going to take the inside. Just take all the green you can get.
That's the biggest play of the day for the Raiders. Back to Atkinson on the ground. And the burst by George into the secondary. And another first down for Oakland at a gain of 15.
He's had some success here tonight.
Following behind the likes of Johnson Riggs and David Sharp, Roni Omoile, Ian Silverman. Along that front line. Trips to the left here. Atkinson will run that way. Bouncing to the outside. Shoved out around the 28 by Thorpe.
It's one thing George doesn't have is exceptional speed. But he does have an ability to be able to bounce it to the outside. So he's going to get as much as he can get. He's got that angle right there. You see Thorpe took it away. He's a faster player. But doesn't stop from picking up 5 yards.
9 carries, 60 yards tonight for Atkinson.
Nice night.
Second and 6. Crockett lost a couple. Rodney Coe with the tackle. So we're going to set up a third and eight here for the Raiders.
Holton's checking in.
Raiders 3-for-8 tonight on third down conversions.
Yeah, gotta be careful with the clock here.
Down to one. They get the playoff in time. Pressure coming up the middle. Incomplete. Looking for Brett down at the 5, and the flag is down.
Pass interference. Defense number 23.
It's Nico Fulton, baby.
First down.
Been going after him all night.
So he doesn't get his hands on him. So now you're just letting him run. He does use the sideline well, but that's what I guess they called it. He pushed him out.
Yeah. Ends up costing the Seahawks 17 yards. And the Raiders will have it first and 10 from the 13-yard line into the red zone, looking for the lead here late in the third quarter. Five wide again. Cook looking left for Holton, incomplete. Shoved by Mike Morgan, second down.
See the backer? Yeah, so he gets a little, and he's in within, he's within 5 yards anyway. But see the defense at the running, it's kind of, it's called a switch. So he's lined up on the inside guy, and he's watching the outside player. He goes out and he just picks the next guy up. Cook misreads it, it could be 6 yards.
Atkinson, nice cut to the left, inside the five, diving for the goal line, and in for the touchdown. What a penalty flag down, back at the 12.
Defense number 68. 10-yard
penalty.
Holding on the
right. Silverman. They've had success with that play all night long. And all, what it is, you start one way and then he's cutting back to the left side. He's had success right over there. See how he starts to the right. Now he's going to cut back to the left side. Now Silverman is right there.
That didn't look too bad.
No. Jack Del Rio certainly didn't like the call. Neither did Tice. They didn't think there should have been a flag there. Second and 20 now, back outside the 20. Cook, Crockett, down the 18. Clock will run under a minute to go here in the third.
So you got to be smart with the ball. You can't throw any pitches. You still want to get 3 out of it, but you'd like to get 6.
Going to be third and 14. The Raiders would need to get down inside the 3-yard line. Now comes back to the right, looking inside the 5, and the catch is made by Hatcher, but I think they're going to say he's out of bounds.
Yeah, he's out of bounds.
So the field goal unit will come on.
The right foot looks like it goes out of bounds before the left foot comes down. There's the catch, there's control, but the right foot hits that sideline before the left foot comes down. That's a heck of an effort.
Jack threw the flag.
I think he did throw the challenge flag.
Oakland is challenging the rule on the field of an incomplete pass.
And there is a challenge for the Raiders here on that. What was ruled an incomplete pass for the Raiders. We'll be back in a moment.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. The receiver's second foot came down out of bounds. It'll be fourth down. Oakland will be charged one timeout.
Actually, man,
so it's the first one.
To 10 seconds.
And there's the first one right there. It's clear that he's out of bounds right there. And then the second one actually was in. Now, I want to show you something because this is really good officiating right here. Is there exactly where, see, right here? He's looking right down here. This official, he goes right here. And then they collaborate on it. You can see the first one is out of bounds. The second one, his left foot, is actually in. Good officiating.
Tavecchio, 36 yards for the lead, and it is no good. Missed it wide left.
Atne Erive Udge, Enact Faye.
Have the lead, and it goes by the wayside.
Inky stay.
Translation, that was no good from Tavecchio. And the Raiders had a chance to grab the lead, and it goes by the wayside. Not by much, but it's gonna go outside the left upright. Raiders come up just short, and Seattle will take over on their own 26-yard line.
And right about now, both teams, they may be at the first down. They'll start to bite hard on the outside trying to make a play, and that's where you get something big down the middle.
Cook gets the first down out to the 25 to Hatcher.
Put the ball down.
You can't hold our guy down!
It's taking way too long.
Down under 30 seconds. Cook under pressure. He's going to get sacked. Ball is out. And Cook was able to secure it.
Yeah, I thought that defensive end had to jump on the ball, actually. Thought he jumped the count. He got a great takeoff if he didn't.
Now the Raiders have used their final timeout here.
Timeout, Oakland. Their third and final timeout. Please set the game clock to 14 seconds.
We'll add on two more seconds for Oakland.
Yeah, see that? You see him on the top side, number 51, that's Morgan?
Yep.
Yeah, it looks like he jumped the gun.
Was not called. So perhaps a couple of plays left for the Raiders. Throws the out route to Brent, gets out of bounds to stop the clock. 10 seconds left.
You about 12 yards.
Going to be third and 12 here. They need to get out to at least the 35 for the first down, but the clock's certainly more important here.
Well, if you can get a first down, then you're going to have to take one shot. Yeah. That's it.
The way the nation is united when they see them Pirates fans get excited. The opposition.